Say, excuse me, love. I says, go to the corner store and get me a cold drink. I'm about to go make me some gumbo. Period. Period. Excuse me, love. I want to be from New Orleans so bad. And are you a makers? Are you always ignorant? Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl, Lot Goddess. Welcome back to my corner where I inspire others to dream more, live more, and become more. I have to start this video off by saying thank y'all for 2,000,000. And what Cardi say? If it's up, then it's a boom, boom, pat. A boogie boogie boo. Thank you guys so much for 2,000 subscribers. Whether you have subscribed to my channel a long time ago or whether you literally just found my channel maybe today or yesterday or this week, I just want to say thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for watching my videos. Continue to subscribe to my channel. Continue to share and watch my videos. And yeah, let's get into it. So today's video is another hair video because y'all love the hair videos, okay? We are going to be talking about why your locks are not growing. And these tips that I'm going to be giving you guys, it's gonna be centered around maybe why your locks aren't growing. Like maybe you've had your locks for a year or maybe 2 years and you notice that your growth just stops. Like when it comes to locks, one of the main reasons why I got locks is because they are low maintenance, okay? So the thing about low maintenance, I feel like it's a good and a bad thing. There's like pros and cons of locks being low maintenance. Sometimes people can get like a little too lazy with their hair and not follow certain things that they're supposed to follow. My number one tip as to why your locks may not be growing is that you do not have a routine. So a routine essentially is like basically what you do to maintain your hair on a weekly or even a daily basis. So if you have not checked out my last lock video where I showed you guys my lock like maintenance routine, particularly at night, I'll be sure to link it somewhere on the screen as well as down below so y'all can check that out. But watch this one first and then you can go watch that one, okay? Okay. When I say no routine, specifically I would say when it comes to moisturizing your hair. So I oil my scalp at minimum 3 to 4 times a week. I do my edges, I do the center of my head, and I also just go all over. So one of the main things that my lactician like taught me when I first went to her, look at your locks like a plant, okay? When you have a plant, what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to water it, give it sunlight, plant food, all that good stuff. So your locks are the same exact way, okay? If you're waking up every single day and you're going about your business, but you're not doing anything to moisturize your locks, you're not putting no oil on it, you're not putting no water, you're not giving your hair enough love, then of course what's gonna happen is your hair is gonna break off and it's not gonna love you back. Me personally, I would suggest spray your hair every single day with water. Oil your hair at least 3 to 4 times a week. Make sure that your scalp is not getting too dry. When you're giving your hair oil and when you're like watering your hair like you're supposed to and when you're spraying it like you're supposed to, that's how your roots are going to get stronger and that's how they're essentially gonna grow. And I would say, especially if you have starter locks, get into the habit of getting a routine early. Like don't wait, you know, until 5 years in and you decide, okay, now I'm gonna start taking care of my locks. No, because again, your locks are not gonna love you back if you don't love them first. All right, the number two reason as to why your locks may not be growing is that you are pulling off your ends, or whenever you have breakage, you're pulling them off, okay? I know that it's really hard. I used to have a really bad habit of pulling off my ends. What your lactician can do, if you show her, you know, like let her know in advance that some of your ends were kind of trying to break off, what they can do, they can actually kind of like reattach those areas that seem to be getting kind of like loose, if that makes sense. Please, please, please do not pull the ends of your hair. I know it's tempting because it's like it's just dangling. I mean, if it's dangling by like a thread, I ain't gonna tell you not to pull it, but I would say like just don't throw it away, because then next time you go and get your hair done, your lactician can just reattach it to the end of your hair. But it probably seems like your hair is not growing because you're constantly pulling your ends off. So I know it's tempting, but hold on to them and get them reattached next time you visit your lactician. I would say too, when it comes to like the ends, stay away from rubber bands. I do rubber bands, but I try not to keep my styles in for too long because they're gonna make your lock very like thin. If your rubber band is this tight around your lock, if you wait in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 weeks to take your style out, then essentially your lock is gonna start to thin. You know, that hair like in that rubber band is gonna start to thin out and eventually your lock will break off. So, you know, in order to avoid breakage, I would say stay away from rubber bands and don't pull your ends off. Okay, number three, too much manipulation. manipulation. And like, honestly, I feel like manipulation can look like so many different things, but more specifically, I'm more so talking about just too many products, or you're trying too many different routines. I have seen people wear wigs over their locks. I've seen people put braids over their locks, just weave in general. Like, I've seen people do a whole lot. Or if you're switching too much back and forth between like interlock and palm roll, all of that is honestly too much. Just like I said in the very beginning, the good thing about locks is that they are very low maintenance, okay? Don't do too much to your hair. Do not, like, leave your locks alone. Do not be putting too many products. Like, how can you expect your hair to grow if you're literally trying a new product every other week? Honestly, you're not even giving certain products enough time to grow your hair. You know what I mean? So I feel like keep it very simple, get you a nice natural oil, and also get you a nice natural shampoo and water. Honestly, those are like the main three things when it comes to locks. That's it. That's literally it. Okay. I know it's tempting to want to just get into so many of like the different products and stuff like that, but to be honest, you're not helping your hair by doing this. You're actually hurting it. And then also when it comes to dyeing your hair, I didn't get dyed until probably like year 12 or 13. Because I was honestly always scared of color, because I was scared that it was gonna like fry my hair. Leave your hair alone. Don't manipulate it too much. Some people literally, like, by the week, they see a YouTube video and boom, they at Target buying the next lock product. They at the beauty supply store buying the next product. Like, don't do all that, sis. Don't do all that. Don't do all that. Somebody need to hear that. If you needed to hear that, comment down below and be like, "Lock, I needed to hear that." Because yeah. Number four, you are leaving your styles in for way too long. And I'm speaking to myself, okay? When you leave your styles in for too long, essentially so many things can happen, right? Kind of like how we were talking about the rubber bands earlier. If you are leaving that in for too long, what will happen is your hair will start to thin out and become very weak, and it'll start to break off. And just like I was talking about earlier, you'll be tempted to pull it off, or it'll just be falling out. Listen, it'll just be a hot mess, okay? So make sure you are not leaving your styles in too long. And I would say too, make sure that you aren't getting styles that are gonna be like too tight, okay? I know, again, you know, with locks, it's very tempting, especially like somebody like me. I have longer locks, so I can do a pretty good amount of styles with my hair, but I choose to not really do that anymore, just because I kind of learned how much of a detriment that was to my hair. Like, for example, I am currently like repairing the middle of my hair because I started getting my hair started thinning out because I was pulling it up too much. So when it comes to styles, you want to, like, I would say play it safe. Like, don't get styles that are going to be too harsh on your edges. Make sure that you're oiling your edges on a regular basis. Also too, even when you have styles in, keep your same routine up. Like, mist your hair on a regular basis. When it comes to oiling your hair, if you can, even with your style in, go around your edges, try to go in between. I would say to be safe, maybe no more than like 2 weeks max for a style. Just because, again, you don't want your hair to break off, especially if you are gonna be using rubber bands on your hair. You do not want those rubber bands sitting in your hair for too long, okay? Make sure that you're taking care of it, even in the style. Tying it up at night like you're supposed to. Make sure that you're putting oil on it, even in the style, and make sure you're misting it as well. Okay, and last but not least, I know some of y'all are probably not gonna wanna hear this, but my number five tip when it comes to why your locks may not be growing is that you are just not being patient enough. Patience is literally all it takes. I know that, like, some of y'all look at people's locks, even my hair. Like, some of y'all probably subscribe to my channel because you feel like, oh my God, her locks are so long. Like, I want mine to be like that instantly. Grow with your locks, okay? Honestly, it's just a very beautiful journey to go on. Like, whenever you make that choice to lock your hair, honestly, this is a permanent decision, okay? So take your time, really think about whether or not you are ready for the journey, because you are going to have patience with your locks, especially if your locks are not at the length that you want them at. The beautiful thing about locks is, like, it's almost, you can look at it like a spiritual growth journey. You can grow with your hair, you know what I mean? So while your hair is growing, take this time to really learn your locks, okay? Your locks are like your babies. Like, they're a part of you forever. The only way you can get rid of them is if you cut them completely off. I mean, there may be other methods, but your locks are your babies, okay? So you wanna treat them with care. You wanna take time. Do not rush the process, y'all. Honestly, like, your locks ain't going nowhere. This is a beautiful decision. This is a commitment, I promise you. It is going to be worth it in the end, okay? So while your locks are growing, like, learn your hair. You know, just make sure that you're doing proper research. Like, during this time, try to just learn different things about your hair. Try to figure out what products work for your hair, what doesn't work, you know, stuff like that. More than anything, I would say just embrace the journey. Honestly, like, it's not gonna be perfect. You're not gonna, like, get it in one day. You're not gonna be a lock expert in one day, and that's okay. Don't be too tempted to try 50 million different things. Like, honestly, just let your hair grow. Locking my hair was probably one of the best decisions I could have ever made. So that's all that I have for you guys today. If you have additional questions about my locks or any additional tips that you would like to know, please drop them down in the comment section. And if you have any other hair video ideas that you would want me to film, then then definitely let me know in the comment section as well. So yeah, again, that's gonna be the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, share with another Locked Diva, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.